degrees of comparison. An adjective, as you know, is a word that describes a noun. It's a word that qualifies a noun. In other words, it's a word that tells something about a noun. We are familiar with a lot of adjectives. In English, an adjective has three different forms or degrees. They are known as positive, comparative, and superlative. Positive, comparative, and superlative. We will examine a few examples to get a clearer and better picture. The first word, the first adjective is tall, T-A-L-L, tall. Tall, taller, tallest. Big, bigger, biggest. Small, smaller, smallest. Long, longer, longest. So in the case of most adjectives, we get the comparative degree by adding ER, the letters E and R after it, at the end of the adjective. In order to get the superlative form, we add EST, EST. So we have tall, taller, tallest. Big, bigger, biggest. So in the case of most adjectives, it is not at all difficult to form their comparative and superlative degrees. Just add ER and EST respectively. But we have a few exceptions. For instance, good. Good. The positive form is good. The comparative is not gooder and the superlative is not the goodest. Instead, they are better and best. So, good is the positive degree, better is the comparative degree, and best is the superlative degree. So is the case of bad, B-A-D. The forms are bad, worse, W-O-R-S-E, bad, worse, and worst. Then we have got a different kind of exception. In the case of long adjectives like important, beautiful, handsome, relevant, significant, we add more and most. So the positive degree is important, its comparative is more important. We don't say importanter, but more important. And of course the superlative is most important. Okay, let us examine three cases here. I am using the same adjective, or more precisely, three forms of the same adjective. The first one, John is a tall boy. It's a simple, plain statement. John is a boy, and what is his speciality? He's tall. So the adjective tall qualifies or adds something to the pronoun boy. John is a tall boy. He is not short or fat or obese, but he is tall. Now, we are going to compare John with someone else. Here, John is not alone. We have got two friends of his, namely Hari and Rahim. So, we say that Hari is taller than John and Rahim. So, there are three boys. Of the three, what is the speciality of Hari? He is taller than John and Rahim. So of the three, who is the tallest? Hari is the tallest among Hari, John and Rahim. Please note that after the comparative degree of an adjective, we use the word than, T-H-A-N. After the comparative degree of all adjectives, we use the expression than. Now we come to the last one. Just as assume that John, Hari, Rahim and Jack, all of them are in the same class. Now, there is Jack. Jack is the tallest boy in the class. What does it mean? All other boys are shorter than Jack. So, the tallest is the superlative degree. Let us read the sentences once again. John is a tall boy. That is positive. Hari is taller than John and Rahim. That is a comparative degree. And finally, Jack is the tallest in the class. That is the superlative degree. So this is the exercise section. We have got six sentences. All of them have an adjective. in one form. It can be a positive, comparative, or superlative. And your task is to change the degree of comparison as directed within the brackets at the end of every sentence. But when you effect the change, when you alter the structure of the adjective, you have to ensure that the meaning doesn't change. You have to ensure that the meaning remains intact. So these are the sentences. The first one, the elephant is the largest animal on the land. Just have a, please pay special attention to the expression the largest. It is a superlative degree. The elephant is the largest animal on the land. And what are you expected to do? You have to change this sentence, or more specifically the adjective part of this sentence, into positive degree, but without affecting the meaning at all. Second, Chennai is bigger than most other Indian cities. Here the degree of comparison is bigger than, that is comparative, so change to superlative. Third one, Cowper. Cowper is the name of a poet who lived somewhere sometime in the 19th century. Cowper is not as great a poet as Wordsworth. Wordsworth was another poet who lived in the 19th century. Your mission is to change it into comparative degree. Iron is more useful than copper. Iron is more useful than copper. More useful, it is comparative. You have to change it into a positive degree. Harish is the cleverest man I've ever met. Here it is superlative, the cleverest, and you have to change it into comparative. Next one, no other country is as rich as America. You have to change it into superlative. And let us see how these changes are effected. Yes, these are the changes. Here we change it into positive. And how do we do that? We use the expression as large as. The complete sentence is, no other animal on the land is as large as the elephant. You may logically think that there is an element of comparison here, because as large as. In a way, you are right, but the point is, we have not used the comparative or the superlative. We haven't used larger or the largest. Instead, we have used the positive degree, large. That is what counts here. In an exercise of this kind, what counts, what matters is the structural features of the word, not what precedes and succeeds it. So this is the method. No other animal on the land is as large as elephant. Try another one. The example we have already seen. Jack is the tallest boy in the class. How do we change that into positive? No other boy in the class is as tall as Jack. No other boy in the class is as tall as Jack. Okay. Now the second one, the original question is, Chennai is bigger than most other Indian cities. It is comparative. And here we are converting it into superlative without touching on the meaning part. So we say Chennai is one of the biggest cities in India. One of the biggest, superlative, but it is not the biggest. There are places like Mumbai and Calcutta and maybe New Delhi which are bigger than Chennai. So what do we do? Instead of saying Chennai is the biggest city in India, we say Chennai is one of the biggest cities in India. Third one, we are using the comparative degree. Originally it was positive. We say Wordsworth is a greater poet than. Greater than. Please note the presence of the word than here. Wordsworth is a greater poet than Cowper. Next one, we say copper is not as useful as iron. We have to use positive degree of the adjective useful. So we don't use more useful or most useful. We simply use the word useful, but we add the same word as before and after it, so we get copper is not as useful as iron. Next one, original is Harish is the cleverest man I've ever met. So we change that into comparative. It is Harish is cleverer than all other men I have met. Cleverer than. Finally, America is the richest country. We are changing the original sentence into the superlative form without changing its meaning. So we get America is the richest country.